lived in the tent for 3 years. We had this great fascination with roughing it and living the wild life.
Living in this tent wasn't easy for Jesse and Tracy.
There was no electricity, there was no water, there was no amenities whatsoever.
We had a compost toilet in an outhouse. After you do your business, everything is supposed to break down, and in the end you end up with dirt. We had a rat move into the compost toilet every time you opened up the lid to the toilet. He was there to greet you. We have endured rain, wind, volcano erupting.
There's 3 active volcanoes in the Big Island, so no matter where you live, it's hard to escape the threat of lava.
We kind of felt unnerved about living next to a volcano.
Lava flows destroy everything in their path. Homes, telephone poles, even plumbing. Some locals are left without water or electricity after an eruption. Once lava has destroyed the infrastructure, it's hard to build back. One-third of the island isn't connected to city utilities, but Jesse and Tracy actually prefer that.
You have to create your own amenities, and if you have solar, you can be self-sufficient.
Jesse works as a mechanic, so he has the skills to make some improvements.
Tracy, she's ready for the completed house, whereas I think I can fix that.
We've done our time in the tent, and I'm totally ready to move into a house.
It'll have to have some form of plumbing, solar, electricity.
I'm really looking for a house that's off-grid.
The Big Island is the least expensive Hawaiian island, but an average home here still costs a third more than on the mainland. So many locals go off the grid to save money on utilities. With a budget of $165,000, they call up realtor Desiree Hughes, who specializes in off-the-grid homes.